I hope that the recording is going pretty fine now. So, hello everyone, and welcome to this presentation on which I will be giving you a brief basics on how you can get started and run your pneumonia detection classification method on your Raspberry Pi using Balina Cloud and Edge Impulse. So, moving on, I have previously clicked on the Deploy with Balina button, and then it gave me an application over at the Balina dashboard, which I have created, and then I will move on to add a new device to it. So I will click on this Add Device option, and I've already previously selected, because the fleet already contains a Balina Fin, which is running along with the Raspberry Pi Compute Model 3. It's a light one, the Compute Model 3 light, because the Fin already has 8 gigs of eMMC storage inside it, which is pretty fast. And the OS I'm using Balina OS, and it's the latest version. Plus, I will use the development option as because it will mostly be used for developers in over this instance. Production images are mainly those images which are being used in some kind of those enterprise solutions and other stuff like that. Moving on, you can use Ethernet or you can use Wi-Fi plus Ethernet. I will use the Wi-Fi plus Ethernet method right now. Putting on my credentials. I will go into the advanced one and I will check that everything is going fine. It says check for updates every X minutes, in which X is equal to 10 minutes. Seems pretty fine. If you want more, then you can reduce the time spaces. But as of now, I'm using the default one, which is 10 minutes. And now I will download up the container image from Balina OS. And we will wait for a couple of minutes for it to download. And then we can move on to flashing it, and then we can continue the further presentation of it. In the meantime, you can have a coffee or you can wait for it. Good, nice. So now our container image has been downloaded, the Balina OS image, and now I will try to flash it on the Balina Fin. So here I am having the Balina Fin along with an attached, I have attached the Raspberry Pi Camera V2. Let me zoom it to you guys so that you guys can also see this thing. This is the Raspberry Pi Camera V2, which will take up the camera feed. And here is the compute module. I guess it's 3 plus light or 3 light. No, it's 3 plus light. And this is the fin, the entire board, very robust one from Balina. So I will go on to flash this thing right using, I will have to connect it to the barrel jack. And also along with the micro USB port, which you get. I'm using a Balina Fin version 1.0, but this is compatible along with other fins as well, the 1.1.1, 1.1, and other stuff. You can also use the same in over the Raspberry Pi, but in that instance, you need to flash it directly to an SD card, and then the SD card needs to be attached to a Raspberry Pi for flashing. Moving on, I will connect this up. Here's the barrel jack. I have connected this up to. Oh yeah, also plus one more thing is that it seems to be booting up. So when you need to connect up your Balina Fin, if I'm flashing it from a Windows-based machine, but I can also flash from a Ubuntu or from a Mac machine or other Linux machines. But the thing which you need to focus on is that you need to have these flasher, the compute model flasher from the Raspberry Pi. You can obviously Google it pretty easily, the compute model 3 plus the Raspberry Pi flasher, and you will get that the zip file which you can extract and then you can run on your machine, which will be then be taking up the data and which will read from the serial port that it will be able to detect that this is the compute model 3 plus and I will have to select it. So seems to be going pretty fine. It says it's connected because I've already downloaded that thing. And I will go on to this. HR is up here. And I will flash from file. This is the thing. And it is initiating the device, which means that it is currently taking up the reading of the data from it. And we will have to wait for a couple of minutes for it, as per the speed of the USB cable which you get plus with the device. It will again disconnect and it will, there you go. I already said I have a 8 gigs of eMMC storage inside it. So it is coming on in over here. I will click on that. Also, you can see it sees resin boot. So Balina previously used to be called as resin, and thus seeing that thing resin boot. Compute model, yeah, let me flash it, size 7.82 gigs, location E drive, select it, and then we will move on to flash it. Yes. Okay, so here we will wait for a couple of minutes according to the speed of your machine which you are flashing through and your Balina pen or the Raspberry Pi. Okay, cool. So it says flash is complete, and I can see that the flash has been completed in over here. So I will again disconnect everything, and then I will connect up from the beginning, and it will show up on the dashboard. Let us start it off, and then I will plug it out. There you go, it gave the sound. I will again switch it off. Then again, I will connect it back to the power supply. Wait for a couple of minutes for it to boot up. And in the meantime, this was my previous device, and similarly, it will also show up the device in over here. It's booting up right now. You can see it from the LED signals which you get in over here, these ones. I will refresh up my page. Hasn't connected up yet. There you go. It's on the page right now, and it's connecting with the dashboard in our Balina. This is the one, wild silence. Cool thing. So we can see that it says online for a few seconds because I just booted it up. And there you go, the magic of Balina. You can see in over here that the, I will move it back to here so that you guys can see my face in here as well. So here you go, you can see the CPU screen. You can see the CPU percentages, plus the memory used, the temperature, and the storage one. Seems to be going fine. Now it will wait for a minute, more than a minute, for everything to boot up, and then it will automatically restart up the containers, download the container images, and then it will automatically start up building that process. In the meantime, I will mute up myself, and then you guys can see a fast video of this scene right in over here. As of now, it sees online, but only the heart but only which sees that it's only blinking the green light in over here. And this thing will download up the container images, which is purely you can see that it sees downloading image. This thing in over right here, it will also downloading this image. Here you go, it's downloaded. It sees that this is the page which you guess. This 0% and it will move on to 100%. So as I said, this is the local address which you get, the local IP address which you can fire up after the container and everything has been downloaded to get the web page view of it. And here's a public one. Plus, if you want, you can switch on to the public device URL so that you can also share it on your device with the other, you know, the other members of this application, which you can also add in over here. And there you go. It's now loading up the Bellina CAM container plus the agent plus inference container. We will wait for a couple of minutes for it to download. Okay, the good thing is that everything has been downloaded, both the Bellina CAM container plus the Edge Impulse container. And here you can see the logs. Let me find it. There you go. Here it was downloading in, and everything seems to be going fine. Yeah, so here you can see that the container is running on port 80 over at my Bellina fin, and then I will minimize it. Cool, so everything seems to be going pretty fine right now, and here you can get to see the local IP address. I will just copy it, and then I will open up Chrome on new tab, and then I will paste it in over here. I will again fire up my browser, and here it's still opening up. It will connect up. There you go. You can see up the screen. And I will take back my camera. And there you go. You can see off the live image from the camera, which has been connected up to the Bellina fin. This will be a bit late, as it depends, normally according to the conditions going on, you know, right to the network connection and the download speed and other frequencies and other connections issues going on. If your connection is a bit low, then it will go down a bit, but not that. You can obviously click up tons of images using these, and then you can classify it pretty accordingly. And here you can see that it sees connection over Bellina VPN. And here are the labels. We have three different kind of the labels: the bacteria, normal, and virus. Plus, also we are having the anomaly detection feature in over here. And so yeah, this was it. And then if you turn on these two, might be the images of X-rays or other stuff, which will be pretty easy for you to then classify using the Bellina fin along with the Edge Impulse container. Push to it using Bellina OS, and then I will search up for an image into our repository, and then I will again show you what's the percentage of it. So yeah, this was it. Then you can show up that to an X-ray, the camera up to an X-ray image, or you can also download the images from our dataset, from the Kaggle dataset that we have given a link up in the GitHub repository, as well as the Hackster project link. And you can click on that. And yeah, this was it. Happy hacking. Bye.